We know about great Pinot Noir from Oregon and Cabernet from Washington, but wines of the Northwest go well beyond this. Our wine and spirits expert and founder of Dallas Uncorked, Hayley Hamilton Cogill, was just up in the air, brought it back a selection from the region, sure to please any palate. And whatever you bring in, I love.
Thank you, Cindy.
And along with what you bring in the bottle, I love what you bring in from your heart.
Thank you.
And the way you're so passionate about what you do.
I do love a good glass of wine. That is.
You said you got inspiration from your aunt.
I did. My aunt is a writer. She was always a fantastic cook, and there was always wine in her house. And so it was anytime we would go and visit, I always was very interested in what she was cooking and what she was pairing with it. And that was kind of the start of my passion for
wine.
Well,
it's carried you well.
And exactly. And now 40-something years later, I still
Okay, tell me what we're doing here.
So most people do know that Pinot Noir in Oregon, that is the grape of Willamette Valley. Cabernet Sauvignon has done really, really well up in Washington in the Walla Walla region. But there are so many different wines. The first one we've got and what we have in our glasses from David Adelsheim. Adelsheim's Oak Sauvignon. And if you look at the
Oak
Sauvignon. I'm so not a Frenchman, but I mean, if you look at it, it's spelled A-U-X-E-R-R-O-I-S. So it doesn't look like how you pronounce it, but I love this wine because it's very, very crisp. It's got great acidity. It's a fantastic food wine. So if you are thinking of like if you're having a creamy pasta, something like mm-hmm. that, it would really cut through some of that fat and just the crispness, the lightness. I also think it's a fantastic patio wine. It is young, so you'll see there's a little bit of effervescence just because it is such a young wine, but you're
yes.
going to want to drink it young. And I just love it, and it's something really special. He's probably the only winemaker in the United States I have seen make it. They're making some up in Canada also, but I think it's kind
yes,
of a special
Yes, I've never
wine.
Heard of it
yeah.
before. And may I ask you, does chilling a white wine enhance the flavor? In other words, are some wines better if they're really cold and some whites better if they're tepid?
Yes, really, really bad wines. Really bad white wines are really good if you just chill them down.
All right, so, what are we doing
so
here?
So then the next one is actually a Chardonnay. It's from Soder, and you wouldn't think Chardonnay is kind of an unusual variety, but up in Oregon it is. It took Oregon a while to figure out the kind of fruit that they should, the kind of Chardonnay that they should plant up there. And Tony Soder, who is well known for his Soder Pinot Noirs, has made this very special. It's their first release, their 2011 Reserve North Valley Chardonnay. And it's really, really special. It has some nice crispness and good acidity, but also brings in some of those kind of honeysuckle, creamy kind of lemon
curd. You mentioned honeysuckle.
Kind of
that's
notes. Yeah, it's a really special wine.
Now, we move down to rosés.
A couple different rosés.
Okay, what are rosés made of? I mean, what's the blend of the...
Well, it's whatever different rosés are going to be made from different grapes. And you'll see rosé for anything from Pinot Noir, like we have here from Stoller, to Malbec, to Sangiovese. We also have one from Charles.
And so is the color of the wine just from one grape?
From the fruit that is inside that bottle.
Oh.
And usually it's made by bleeding off the grapes. I'm not going to pronounce that French term, but it's usually they bleed the grapes and you just get the perfect kind of color that you want. It also adds a little bit of that tannin that you expect from a red wine without being too heavy.
Too heavy.
This one from Stoller, it's so special. It's probably my favorite rosé right now. It is a Pinot Noir, but in a rosé. I think it tastes like ruby red grapefruit and watermelon.
That sounds enticing.
It's just delicious. It's a great, and I always try to keep one bottle, which is hard to keep one through the summer, but it's a great Thanksgiving wine also.
Yes, it seems so.
I love it.
And now, what's the difference in these two? This is Charles
and Charles. This one is from Washington State. It's actually made with Syrah, Cinsault, and Grenache. And so,
that's a different.
Different varieties
yeah.
that go into the bottle. This is more kind of the grapes of the Rhone region. So mm-hmm. sometimes you think of like a Provence rosé. Those are what a lot of people consider to be the most fantastic rosés. I agree. This one's a little bit deeper. You can just tell that
yes,
the color is a little bit richer.
I'm dying to try these.
But
two.
Really, really special. We'll see if we can open
them. Okay, Mackie.
And then we've got a couple other wines from Washington State. Mackie is has also used those same Rhone varieties. Syrah, Grenache, Mourvèdre do really well in those Oregon or in the Washington State soils. This one is from Columbia Valley. It brings in a lot of those kind of smoky spice notes mm-hmm. of a good Syrah with cherry and a really, really nice, lively kind of finish.
See,
it's
you're
wine.
Mentioning flavors and things, yeah. And this one?
The last one is Frederick's Spring Valley. It does have Cabernet in it, but they also blend in a lot of other things like Merlot and Petit Verdot. And so the blends of Washington really kind of stand out. They're fantastic wines, especially, I think, as Memorial Day is coming up, Father's Day.
You would
recommend
these.
These are barbecue wines. Yeah, they're
barbecue
wines. Absolutely.
Oh, my gosh.
Steaks.
You know what I love about her? Number one, we get to sample all these flavors. I get educated. I want to know more. And you can learn more about all these great wines by going to Hayley's website, DallasUncorked.com. When we come back, we're catching up with the band Delta Ray, who recently appeared at the highly successful Suburbia Music Festival in Plano. Stick around.